But I'll tell you what, folks, the world isn't being won today because we're not doing it. It's our fault. This generation of Christians is responsible for this generation of souls on the earth. And nowhere in the world is the gospel so plentiful as in the United States. Nowhere. And I don't want to see us stand before God on that day and say, "But God, I didn't hear you call me." Here's something for all you to chew on. You don't need to hear a call. You're already called. In fact, if you stay home from going into all nations, you'd better be able to say to God, "You called me to stay home, God. I know that as a fact." I want to see the hands of everybody here that's heard a definite call from God not to go into all nations and preach the gospel. Raise your hand. One. Two. Two. It might be three or four that I missed. Well, the rest of you are called, unless God tells you otherwise, before you leave on your airplane trip or hitchhike across the ocean or whatever you're going to do. Now, don't go out and sell everything and leave tomorrow. Get some training. You don't need a college degree necessarily. Sure is a good reason to go to college, though. I know so many kids that go to college, they don't even know that God's told them to go. They don't know why they're there. Everybody else in church is going, and mom and dad wants them to go. That's good enough for them. Well, I'll tell you what, it ain't good enough for Jesus. He wants you to be in his army, and he wants you to take orders from him. And sure, he wants you to submit to your parents. But he wants you to find out what your Father in heaven has to say first. What does he have to say for you? If you don't hear anything, know this. You are called to go. There's a rule in the armed forces. Always obey the last order you got until you get new orders from command headquarters. The last order I got in my Bible was go.
Church